Is Evernote making a comeback? No, seriously, guys, I am mind-boggled recently as Evernote's been making crazy updates, and not in a bad way, because I used to really bash on Evernote because it did go downhill for years. But if you recall, they recently got bought out by a company called Bending Spoons. Really weird name, very good results. They've made a large number of updates recently, and their Twitter has been a great place to look. So if you are ever just wondering what products have updates going on, I would go on Twitter for a lot of this stuff. It really does showcase what's going on. They are also doing a monthly recap every month, which is a thing that a lot of different companies do. And I also do for companies. So if you're a software company looking for services for your business, make sure to check us out in the link down below, riseproductive.com/content-services. Some updates that are added to the system recently have been things like native events, as well as in the events, to-do lists with specific due dates. So for example, if I set this to today and went to my home and looked at my calendar, it has tasks and events syncing from my Google Calendar here. And Evernote even has its own native events now, which is pretty cool. You'll notice here that I can press new event and I can say record this video, not even record this video, like drive to the city, for example. And you'll notice that the option for calendar is Evernote calendar here. And that's because this is actually just within my calendar, right? This is crazy to me. Notion doesn't have this, and I know that, you know, God forbid I make a comparison to Notion in every video, but Evernote has been around for years. They have been around for such a long time that they don't actually have a spot in people's head for a while where, you know, like, where are they gonna go? Up? Because if you took a look at this, and this is one of my favorite things to do, and you just look up Evernote in search terms on Google Trends, and you look at it from 2004 to present, it was on the downswing, and it continues to be only having some relatively small bumps probably when the purchase happened and recently. But I'm telling you, this app is not on the downswing. It having a native feature for calendar events, tasks, and this all to be done within a note, for example, and syncing to a calendar. When I go to this calendar page, you'll notice here that I have my Google Calendar built in, which is awesome. And I can connect multiple calendars here. And I only have my like meeting events here, but I could add more of them, like life events. Like for example, I'm gonna go watch a comedy show tonight and it'll pop up right here. And I can click on this, delete the events. I don't like that I can't drag this around, right? I try to click and drag. I do have to press right click on something or left click on something for the tasks. It's a little bit wonky in comparison to like a normal daily planner, but the ability to be able to add a note to something like this, like maybe where do I wanna go for dinner in Rockford? So like action items, figure out where to go for dinner in Rockford. And then if I went back to my home, you'll notice that I can't spell Rockford to save my life, but if I press save here, then I have a homepage where I see a task that was written in a note pop up here. I have this relevant to my calendar in this section. I can change the view here from a day to like a schedule view. So I can just see it like stacked like this, including the tasks. I can go to different days. I can just write on a scratch pad. This is kind of a better note-taking experience for quick notes than even something like Notion, to be honest. I haven't had any lag with this. I think a big issue that I had with Evernote in the past was that it was extremely laggy. Like I won't lie to you, like it was pretty pathetic. Like just not even being able to download the desktop app like 2 years ago. There was a video of me literally showing how I couldn't download the desktop app. But now it's easy, it's quick, there's action items, there's notes. There's not the same kind of markdown functionality as you expect in some products where there's like a forward slash, but at least there is things like brackets can turn it into a checkbox. And you can obviously do things like make headers and smaller headers. All of the basic markdown stuff's there. There's no like drop down. But if you're looking for something that's like an elevated version of a note-taking app, like OneNote or even Microsoft Word, you can write really well inside of Evernote. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. It's pretty solid. And they did recently introduce a AI edit beta, which I'm not gonna try out for these purposes, but similar to everything else, there's Gen AI capabilities in here. So if you wanna see anything more regarding Evernote or learn more about it, I mean, it's got a lot going for it now. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm kind of excited for where Bending Spoons continues to take this product, but I wanted to show you how snappy it is, how moving in the right direction it is for the first time in what feels like 5 years, maybe even a decade. So make sure to check out Evernote today and check out this video on how to improve your skills using tools like this one even more.